We are from school.
Nice to see you.
Come on in. Hello. Nice to meet you.
Hi.
How are you?
Oh, how lovely. So, hang on, the big balloon adventure. We saw you go over Africa in the balloon, didn't we?
Yes, you did last year. Now this is Australia.
And it only happened, really, because your pilot said, I've got a race in Australia.
Exactly, yes. There's a big international balloon festival in a place called Canoundra.
Mm-hmm.
So we had 4 weeks to toughen up, get to... see as much of Australia as we can and get into the psyche of what it's like to be an Aussie to try and beat them in their backyard representing Great Britain.
Aha! And how many are there in the Australian teams?
I think there were about 18 balloons in all.
Mm-hmm.
And it's strange, a balloon race isn't sort of a start line and a finish line. You all set off from the same place and you're given coordinates to a big X in a field. And because there's no steering in a balloon, you can go up and down, the rest's up to Mother Nature. You have to try and hug whatever thermals you can and navigate your way over this X. Then each balloon has a marker that you throw and the person nearest to the X is the winner.
A bit like balls.
A little
from
bit.
From the air.
A little bit.
There's quite a lot of spitting, isn't there, with ballooning to check the...
There is.
..the wind direction.
Yes,
you spit
absolutely.
Over the edge
it's
and
technical.
See where it goes. Yeah,
it's scientific.
It's,
yes, it's not rude.
And the landing, the landing is the first
landing that we had, we were in the outback, flying over the Flinders Ranges, which is a huge mountain range, and we flew over a sort of rock amphitheatre called the Wilpena Pound, and the weather changed while we were up there. And so the landing that we made was we hit the ground at 40 miles an hour. In a laundry basket.
Let's have a look at it, because it does look quite scary.
OK.
They just feel like the only people on the planet.
But despite all the planning, our balloon flight over the Flinders Ranges ends in a way none of us expected.
Get ready, lads. Yeah. Hold on now. Brace.
See what was happening, but the aftermath, and you came out with some injuries.
I broke two teeth.
Two
teeth at the back.
Did you? Because you're grinding like that.
Yes, and you, as I say, you face away from the way you're travelling, and I ended up sort of hanging upside down. We were dragged for over 1,000 feet because the balloon then becomes like a sail on a yacht, and we were dragged through a rocky outcrop.
And how long does the whole race take?
The whole race, well, it only lasts a couple of hours, but it's the training, Fern. It's 4 weeks. 4 weeks.
Yeah, sorry, yeah, of course. Yeah. Got your muscles. You've been so busy and got so many things coming up. You've only just, I think, a few weeks ago, finished filming a new series about, is it DCI Banks?
DCI Banks, yes.
From these fantastic novels. I don't know if any of you read these
crime
novels.
By Peter Robinson.
Yeah. And there's 19 of them?
There's 19 of them, and we've just done one as a pilot, a case called Aftermath, which we filmed in Leeds. And, yes, it should be out in September.
So what sort of things does Banks do? Foibles of a detective.
Yeah, he's the sort of guy you want working for you, not looking for you.
Mm.
He's very dogged, very determined, he shouldn't really be a policeman. He takes it all too personally. He's a bit like a Native American Indian who didn't want their photo taken because they believed part of their soul would be taken. Mm. It's sort of each case nearly... takes an awful lot out of
it. Scoured London and got a piece of the stuff that you've shot recently, which I don't think is even fully edited yet.
Good
so
Lord.
Have a little look at this.
Do you know Janet Taylor, sir?
Well enough to know she did everything by the book.
And what about Dennis Morrissey? Do you know him too?
I know he was murdered by Marcus Payne. If you want to question me officially, D.S. Cabot, get a date in my diary. Otherwise, there's your crime scene.
Thank you, sir.
Is she higher ranking than you?
then?
No, no, she's she works for Professional Standards, which is like internal affairs. So we're working on the same case, but from opposing ends. So,
so she's like the trading standards officer to make sure you're doing it correctly.
Exactly.
How irritating. And that, that first pilot, as you say, is all about a serial killer, so...
Yeah.
Ooh, yeah. Grim. And, of course, you're doing the More For Book Club.
Yes.
Have you started that?
Yes, we've... I've done the first half of it, so yep. I have four books to read out of the eight chosen for the summer read.
Is it quite nice to sit and read a book and
it's
say,
gorgeous.
I'm working, I have to read a novel?
And because they, you know, they're recommended, you know, there's a process that goes through before we get the book, so they have been well-thumbed and... And they have all been really interesting, not necessarily books you'd pick yourself, but someone chooses them for you. And it's great. I mean, books offer such gorgeous escapism.
What would you choose?
I still... Well, the books that I was read to as a child, I still love revisiting, so I still love Winnie the Pooh, the A.A. Milne books. Treasure Island is still the best adventure story ever written. Dickens, I loved. I was one of those odd kids at school who really loved Charles Dickens.
Yes, I've tried of Two and City, I can't do it. I'd love to be able to do it, but I can't. Can't do Dickens yet. Not grown up enough, I think. Anyway, More For Book Club is on Sunday evenings, and go and have a look at our website for anything if you want to go and have a look at favourites and how to vote for the best.
Yeah.
And then as well... This man is the only person on British television, Alastair, as you can understand. you are also doing Wild at Heart coming up in the autumn.
Yes, we fly out on Tuesday back to South Africa, and I'll be there till nearly Christmas. And it'll be back on your screens in January. So we're thrilled to be going back again.
And who is Hamley?
Hamley is a very gorgeous boy giraffe. Who's very inquisitive. He's often to be found in the makeup trailer every morning.
Having his eyelashes done.
Oh, absolutely. And they're eyelashes to die for. And he follows us around all day when we're filming. And Vicky Brooker, who looks after all the animals on the farm, says he gets quite depressed when we leave.
Oh.
And he just stays looking at the gate and he waits for 7 months till we all come back again.
Oh, you can't wait to see
him. No, I can't wait. I dream about him when I don't see him. So
And what about the baboon who thinks he's a dog?
Oh, that was on the previous balloon adventure. Yeah, a baboon called Bobby, who's been adopted by a herd load of goats, and he just lives with them. And rides them and gets milk from them and looks after them as well. You should get him on this show.
That would be nice. Ladies and gentlemen, Bobby and Hamley.
That would be lovely.
We've flown Hamley all the way here to say hello to you.
That would be gorgeous.
That would be great. And your daughter Daisy, she can join you in the school holidays, can she?
She does indeed, yeah. She's been out there for the last 5 years. She knows all the animals. She's a big fan of Hamley's, so it's a real treat for
her
dad.
She's been going since she was a little girl, hasn't
Absolutely,
she?
Yeah.
Growing up with all these animals.
She's grown up with there's a new pride of lions there that will be 5 years old now, so they're all fully grown. But Daisy was in the playpen with them when they were first born for the first 3 weeks before they got their teeth, obviously. It's gorgeous for a
dad. What a wonderful life you have. Fantastic. And you'll have to come back and tell us about
I've got a play.
The new year play being a psychopathic murderer.
I'm playing a psychopathic murderer in a play called Faith and Cold Reading by Sean Prendergast, which is on at the Live Theatre in Newcastle, middle of January to the middle of March.
He's never going to stop, is he?
I hope not.
Let's hear it. For Stephen Tompkinson.
Thanks for getting all that in.